We're standing now at the threshold of the Yomim Noiroim, the days of awe, the days of fear. The Magen Avraham says that the Yomim Noiroim officially start with Slichas. Now the big question is, we know that on Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur, we try three things: tshuva, repentance, tefillah, davening, and tzedakah, to give charity. So the question is, why is it that we start the process of the days of awe, the Yomim Noiroim, with the inyan of tefillah? Why don't we have a big collection now? Everyone should give tzedakah, or maybe to do tshuva. Why is it that we start with tefillah, the slichas? That is the introduction. That is the way we step in to the Yomim Noiroim. So the Mefarshim explain, the reason for that is because the koyach of tefillah, the power of davening, is so strong that it overrides anything else. And there are many, many indications and many places that we find this inyan about the koyach of tefillah, the power of davening. I would like to share a Talmud Yerushalmi. The Gemara Yerushalmi brings a fascinating story that happened with Menashe HaMelech. Menashe HaMelech, the King Menashe, he was a Jewish king, a descendant of David HaMelech, and he reigned in the period of the first Beis HaMikdash. Unfortunately, the Pasuk tells us in Sefer Melachim that he was a big sinner. He did tremendous averus, including Avodah Zarah. He introduced bringing in idols into the sanctuary of the Beis HaMikdash. Imagine people coming to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to bring korbanos, and he decided that he put up idols in the Beis HaMikdash. We can imagine how angry the Ribbono Shel Olam became from that. The Pasuk tells us that eventually Menashe HaMelech repented. He did tshuva. But there's a story behind it. And the story goes as follows. At that time, the big enemy of the Jews were the Assyrians, the Melech Ashur. So the Pasuk says that the Melech Ashur, the king of Assyria, captured Menashe. And he decided to kill him in a most brutal way. They took a big copper pot. They filled it up with water. They put him into the pot. They locked it. They locked the lid. And they put a fire underneath the pot. And they wanted to cook him. They wanted to kill him in that way. And as soon as Menashe HaMelech started feeling the heat, he decided, he started praying, he started davening to all the Avodah Zarahs that he was familiar with. He knew all the idols. He knew them by first name. So he went through the whole list of all the idols that he worshipped all the years before that. And obviously, there was no answer. So he says, I remember when I was a young child, Menashe HaMelech's father was a big tzaddik. He was Chizkiyahu HaMelech, the king Chizkiyahu. So when he was a young boy, his father took him to cheder, he took him to Jewish school. And he says, I remember learning in cheder a pasuk in Parshas Va'eschanon, where the pasuk says, Batzar lecha umtza'ucha kol advarim o'eile. The Ribbono Shel Olam is saying that when things will get tight and things will get, the going won't be so smooth, and you'll remember HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you'll do tshuva and he'll accept your tshuva, he'll accept your repentance. So Menashe HaMelech started davening to the Ribbono Shloim and he said, if the Ribbono Shloim answers my prayers, he answers my tefillos, I will know that there is a Ribbono Shloim. And all of a sudden, the angels, the Malachim in Shamayim, saw that the tefillos of Menashe start coming up, and they said, there is no way that we are allowing his tefillos, his prayers, to even come anywhere near the Kisei HaKavod. How could we allow such a Rasha, such an evil person, to daven and his tefillos should be accepted? So there are special windows, says the Gemara, the Yerushalmi. There are special windows in Shamayim through which the tefillos of Klal Yisrael, when we daven, those tefillos go up through those windows. The Malachim started stuffing the windows. They put things into the windows that the tefillos shouldn't come up. And the Ribbono Shloim said, if I don't accept the tefillah of Menashe, what will happen? People will say that you can't do tshuva. Here you have someone who's trying to do tshuva and he's not being accepted. So the Ribbono Shel Olam made a new window, which no one expected. And through that window, the tefillah of Menashe came through, and the Ribbono Shel Olam saved him from that pot, and he went on to do tshuva and to do the right thing. What do we see from this Yerushalmi? We see from this Gemara that when a person is sincere, and when a person davens from his whole heart, regardless of his background, regardless of what he did, and regardless for how many years he did it, the Ribbono Shel Olam will accept our tefillos. Because tefillah, davening, what is the inyan of davening? The Rabbeinu Yonah says that when a person davens, he shows that he believes in the Ribbono Shel Olam. Because if he wouldn't believe, why is he davening? So davening to the Ribbono Shel Olam shows that you have emunah, you believe. If a person believes, the Ribbono Shel Olam reciprocates and he accepts our tefillos. And that is why when we start the concept and the inyan of the Yomim Noroim, the first thing we do is the inyan of slichas, the inyan of davening, because the power of davening, the power of tefillah is as strong as ever. So Be'ezes Hashem, we have an excellent chazan who's going to lead our slichas, and he's going to bring us into the mood, sort of, the Yomim Noroim. And I just wanted to mention that the evening tonight is Le'ilin Nishmas Machlobas Osher Zeleg Halevi. May the tefillos be an aliyah to her neshama. Agud Tavach.
Oh, Yeah.